Hello again, everyone, and welcome back to Learn Linux TV. In this video, what we're going to do is set up a dual boot between Windows and Linux Mint. It's going to be awesome. As always, I'll take you through the process every step of the way, and by the end of this video, you'll be able to choose between Linux Mint and Windows every time you start your computer. Now, it probably goes without saying, but you should definitely back up your computer before we get started. Now, obviously, I don't really think anything bad is going to happen, but it's always good to err on the side of caution. In particular, what I'm going to do in this video is take a system that already has Windows installed in a situation where Windows has taken over the entire drive, and what we're going to do is shrink it and install Linux Mint. It's going to be awesome. And I can't wait to get started, but first, I need to make sure that you're aware of the fact that I have two brand new courses available over on Udemy. First, if you're in the process of learning Linux for the very first time, you should definitely check out my Linux Essentials course. Not only will this course teach you everything you need to know to get started and learn the basics of Linux, it's also going to help you get certified and earn your Linux Essentials credential through LPI. And the Linux Professional Institute is the world's largest Linux and open source focused vendor-neutral certification body, so by earning certifications through LPI, your credentials will be recognized around the world. But even if you don't have any interest in getting certified, this course is still a great fit for those of you that are getting started with Linux because it'll teach you all the basics. Also, I recently released an Ansible course as well, which will teach you everything you need to know to get up and running with Ansible. Ansible is one of, if not the most popular configuration and automation platforms in the Linux ecosystem, so it's definitely something that you need to learn. Ansible is a powerful and easy-to-learn platform that'll enable you to automate even the most complicated Linux administration tasks. And just like with my Linux course, each lesson will break down even the most complicated components and concepts into easy-to-understand lessons. And by the end of the course, you'll learn everything that you need to know to use Ansible as part of your daily toolset. And thank you guys so much for checking out my courses. I really appreciate it. Now it's time to set up our dual boot, so let's get started. First, I'll log into Windows. And here we are. Now, the first thing that I recommend you do is update Windows. Just make sure that everything is completely up to date. I've already done that off camera, so I won't have to do that this time, but just make sure that everything is up to date before you get started. Next, what we'll do is open up a web browser. And what we'll do is navigate to linuxmint.com. Then we'll click on download. We can scroll down and choose an edition. I'm going to go with the Cinnamon edition for this particular video, but it shouldn't make a difference as far as this process goes. Next, we'll scroll down and we'll choose one of the mirrors that's closer to you to download Linux Mint from. You just click on any of these. So for example, I can click on kernel.org. And it shouldn't matter which one you click on. You'll get the same file. However, I'm going to cancel this because I've already downloaded Linux Mint. What I've done off camera, just to show you right here, is I've created a Ventoy and I threw a few ISO images inside the Ventoy folder right here. And if you don't have a Ventoy installation of your own, then I highly recommend that you set one up. It's also an easy method for installing Linux Mint. You can see that I have the ISO downloaded right here. So with Ventoy, all you have to do is drag the ISO into the Ventoy folder and then boot from that USB flash drive, and you'll be good to go. If you haven't yet set up Ventoy, then I'll leave a card for my Ventoy setup video right here. So check that out if you're interested. Now, I should have everything that I need. Anyway, let's restart. And then we'll get ready to access the boot menu for our computer. Each computer manufacturer has a different key combination for accessing that menu, mine is F12. So I'm going to get ready to press F12 and let's see if I can do it in time. All right, here we go. And here's the boot menu for my computer. And the reason why you're able to see my boot menu is because on this channel, I use real hardware for all of my screen recordings unless I tell you otherwise. That way, every time you see a video on my channel, you'll be getting the authentic experience. If that's something that you think is pretty cool, then be sure to subscribe to Learn Linux TV. Anyway, what I'll do is click on my flash drive. And in my case, it's this one right here. And I know that's the case because I've done this probably hundreds of times now. Anyway, I click on this right here. And here you could probably see why I like Ventoy so much. because I could boot from any one of these ISOs or any others that I might add in the future right from one flash drive. In this case, we're going to be installing Linux Mint, so I'll boot from this one. I'll boot it in normal mode. Press enter right here. And here we have Linux Mint. How cool is this? We are actually using Linux Mint in live mode. It's running directly from the flash drive. And the great part about this is that we can use this to test compatibility with Linux Mint before we install it. Now the first thing I'm going to do is correct the display right here because it's just hard for me to see anything. So I'll just increase the scaling a bit. I think 200% should be good enough for me. And I think that's much better. Sorry to interrupt my own video, but I just wanted to let you know that I appreciate each and every single one of you, and I love creating Linux-related content for you guys. But unfortunately, producing high-quality Linux content like this isn't cheap. But if you want to help me make even more content for you guys, then consider supporting Learn Linux TV. And a great way to do that is to check out the official shop for Learn Linux TV, which was just recently updated. Inside the shop, you'll find distro-themed shirts, bags, drinkware, and more. And there's some other surprises there as well. For example, I've just introduced a mouse pad that doubles as a Tmux cheat sheet. How cool is that? So check out the shop at merch.learnlinux.tv, or you could check out the merch shelf right here on YouTube. You could get yourself something really cool and support Linux learning at the same time, so it's a win-win. Anyway, thank you guys so much for your support. I really appreciate it. Now, let's get back to the video. Now, the next thing that I recommend you do is connect to Wi-Fi. This will give you a chance to ensure that Wi-Fi is working in the first place. So what I'll do is click on mine right here. And it looks like I'm connected. And not only that, it added my printer as well. So that's pretty cool. And now I know that that's going to work. So that's one less thing that I have to test later. Another thing we could do is open Firefox to access a web page just to ensure that that works. That'll also give you an opportunity to ensure that audio works as well. So you could play one of my videos, for example. That's a good way to test. And there we go. So on my end, I think I'm clear to continue. Everything seems fine to me. So what I'll do is click Install Linux Mint. I'll double click on it. And here we have the installer, so I'll click Continue. Then we can choose our keyboard layout right here. So if yours is something other than the default, you could choose that here. You could also test your keyboard by typing into this box right here. Once you're satisfied, we'll click Continue. Now for this, I recommend that everyone check this box right here. It may or may not be necessary, but it's not going to use up all that much extra space. So it should be fine. That's going to ensure that multimedia files will play back properly on your computer. So I can't really think of any reason not to do that. So we'll click Continue. And we want to make sure that we choose the first option right here to install Linux Mint alongside Windows. We definitely don't want to choose this option right here if we plan on dual booting. So we'll leave the selection on this right here and we'll click Continue. Now here what we could do is choose how much space to give Windows and how much space to give Linux. I'll leave mine somewhere in the middle. I think that'll be good enough for me, and I'll click Install Now. At this point, we have one last confirmation before the point of no return. So as long as you've backed up your computer and you're sure that you have everything you need, we can click Continue. Continue again. I guess there was one more point of no return. Anyway, right here, what we're going to do is just click somewhere on the map to choose where our location is. Mine is already pretty much good enough, so I'll leave mine on this selection right here. But what this does is set your time zone, your language settings, and things like that. So that's why it's in your best interest to ensure that it's correct. Anyway, we'll click Continue. And then we'll fill out the information for the first user account of our system. And then we'll click Continue. At this point, Linux Mint will do the rest of the installation work that it needs to do. So what I'll do is fast forward it, and I'll be right back. All right, looks like we're finished. So why don't we test it and make sure that it works? What I'll do is click Restart Now. Next, what I'll do is remove the flash drive. I just want to make sure that it doesn't boot back into the installer again. And now that I've done that, I'll press Enter. And now it's booting up, so moment of truth. And here we have the boot menu. So what I'm going to do is just let it time out and boot into Linux Mint. And here we have the login screen, so I'll type in my password and press Enter. And here we have Linux Mint. It's fully installed on our computer and ready to go. However, at this point, we need to test Windows and make sure that that still works. So what I'll do is just go down here and give that a click. Let's go ahead and restart. And here at the boot menu, what I'll do is go down to Windows and press Enter. And check it out. Here we have Windows. And as you can see, it's working just fine. So now we could choose between Linux Mint and Windows every time we start our computer. And there you go. In this video, we set up a dual boot between Windows and Linux Mint, and I hope you enjoy it. Now be sure to subscribe to Learn Linux TV for the latest in Linux if you haven't already done so, because I have some awesome content coming very soon. In the meantime, though, thank you so much for checking out this video, and I'll see you in the next video.